Tano Falava and welcome back. Well, as we heard earlier, the first of our Pacific Language Weeks for the year starts on Sunday with the Rotuman language. And one of the champions keeping that community's language and culture alive is Fesaitu Solomone, who also happens to head one of the key Pacific language centres in the country. Noa ia e Māori, Fesaitu, thank you for joining us on the show. Whaiexia e te angesia mango e. Welcome. Now, I'm trying to learn a bit of Rotuma to welcome you on here today. Ka e tapta ben.
Whaiexia ka o lele. Wafo pola te angesia ma e I e amnek ni ngarui ni Tangata Pasifika. Ka e tapin.
Whaiexia ka ngau lele. Tapema. I am well too. Oh my goodness, the Rotuma language is so different to many of our other Polynesian languages, isn't it?
Yes, definitely. It's very different in the sense that whilst we're an Austronesian layer of the language as well, our language is derived not just from three layers of the Pacific languages, but also a unique layer with diacritics in our languages. It's also got German umlaut, so it's respectfully, it's very different in the sounds to the other Pacific languages as well.
How hard is that to try and engage, especially our community in New Zealand, to try and learn the language for those who aren't speakers?
Well, that's the interesting part with our language being advocating in the space for quite some time, as our young people have really started to embrace the language itself and learning the language through music, through dance and through the work of our communities as well across Aotearoa. So I'm really interested and happy with the uptake of the language when it comes to our young people and our elders as well and knowledge holders are also supporting the space for our Pacific languages and our Rotuman languages too.
Is it extra difficult being such a small community here in New Zealand?
Yes, it's a very small community here in New Zealand. We, population-wise, through the New Zealand stats, we only had about 981 listed. But I believe as more of our people come over, migrate to New Zealand and Aotearoa, the population will grow. And the work of our Rotuman communities will need to be solid enough to keep supporting our Whiang Rotuamta.
Now, it's listed as endangered. How do you feel as a Rotuman, you know, looking at your language in that state?
Definitely. I mean, 2011, that's when it was first listed in UNESCO as being vulnerable. It's moved to a stage here in Aotearoa, I would say, to your point. It's getting to an endangered space as part of the structure through UNESCO's list of endangered languages. For me, that's why I advocated so hard for our Rotuman language, is that whilst the language still survives back on homeland in Rotuma, the work globally will need to be more supportive in the sense our people need to really understand the value of it. And we're losing that language, which means that a lot of our generations coming up will probably will not be able to speak the language in future. So that's a key point in our work as part of a community. I'm not just by myself, but it's for everybody.
If you lose your language, do you lose your culture?
Absolutely. We all know that through language, we will definitely lose culture. You can't practice culture without the language. And so the elements of language must be embedded first and foremost for us and our identity to be able to practice the cultural aspects and protocols and ceremonial rites as well.
Now, I know there's some really neat digital resources that you've been doing. Hoping people will pick those up and start using them?
Yes, there's a lot of interest in the space, and I know a lot of the time, not just in Aotearoa, in the Pacific region and also globally for our Rotuman community, everybody keeps asking for resources. So it's a way digitally where people learn faster is to learn the language, and Fufupu e Rotuma through Pacific Kids Learning is a way to introduce to a digital platform. We've done a lot of resources digitally everywhere. So there's the availability of that as well.
I mean, resources are key really, to try and engage our young people. And even me, I was recording some of you earlier, you know, just to try to help people have that sense of having that access to it. In your work at PLC, CPL, I'm getting all that initials. In your work there, just tell us, how important is it that it is well-resourced to be able to continue our languages?
Absolutely, it needs a lot of resources. It needs to continue to resource the Centre for Pacific Languages. We not only teach one, we teach 9 Pacific languages now. We've just launched Kiribati. We're looking...
Wow.
Our work aligns with the Ministry for Pacific Peoples Language Weeks, and we've just launched, this year will be 2, PNG and Solomon. So the work for us is very crucial. I would say we are the only space here in Aotearoa and probably globally that we teach more than just one Pacific languages. So it's really crucial for us, not just resourcing us, but the ability for us to look not through human resources as well, knowledge holders, teachers, translators, all of that needs to be well-resourced in order to continue the journey of our languages. And that's to support on what is already existing in our community groups as well as organisations that support our language spaces. Yeah.
What's a big week for Rotuman? Obviously coming up, what's some of the highlights?
There's some key highlights I want to point out. Our New Zealand Rotuman community groups across Aotearoa, Christchurch, Wellington and Auckland are doing a lot of those work. Ngasawa Nefiang Rotuamta, which sits Moirani, is opening tomorrow, as well as throughout the weeks, there's programs from universities, museum as well. They're performing through our tautonga or katoanga, and also language, little language nests as well. I'm also speaking, having some speaking engagements with universities and also organisations and schools to promote the language next week as well.
Thank you so much for coming on the show. And I've got to practice this right. Hold on, hold on, hold on. No ia fesaitu, e te ang e sia mango e. Thank you for coming on the show.
Paiak sia.